She had to agree to do so hard works or to complete hard works of harvesting on her own as well as of Tejpal Singh. Dear students, now we will discuss about the capital arrangement for the big farmers and medium farmers. So, a small farm, the medium and large farmers have their own saving from farming. Most of us belong to medium farmers. Generally, we find that we get saving from farming, about which we will discuss in next section, like the sale of surplus farm products. That's why they are thus able to arrange the capital needed. How do these farmers have their own savings? You will find the answer in the next section. Here, a story has been discussed and some fill in the blanks has been given in a story. By reading this chapter, you can fill up these blanks and you could get answer easily and you could prepare this chapter easily. Students, sale of farm products or sale of surplus farm products. Let us suppose that the farmers have produced wheat on their lands using the three factors of production. It means, suppose we are farmers, we produce grains using three factors of production on our land. The wheat is harvested and production is complete. Suppose we sow wheat on our land. We do harvesting and production is complete because produced come in our homes. What do we do or what do the farmers do with the wheat? Then students, first of all, we keep some wheat for the familiar requirements. Suppose your family requires 8 quintal of wheat annually, or your family consumes 8 quintal of wheat annually. If you or if your father produce 20 quintal of wheat, to subtract 8 quintal for familiar use, then your father or your family saves 12 quintal of wheat. It is surplus product or it is surplus wheat. By selling these this surplus wheat, they do various familiar works or domestic works during agricultural season. They use this surplus wheat to sell them in the market, and money getting from the sale of the surplus wheat use in cultivation. So thus we see that medium and large farmers arrange capital from saving of cultivation or by selling of the surplus crops. They retain a part of the wheat for the family's consumption and sell the surplus wheat. A small farmers like Sajita and Govind's sons have little surplus wheat because their total production is a small, and from this a substantial share is kept for their own family needs. In contrast of medium and large farmers, a small farmers have a small products, that's why they retain some wheat for familiar use, and they have very little surplus products and surplus wheat. Now question rises here that how can they repay the loan borrowed by the money lenders, large farmers and traders. So it is the medium and large farmers who supply wheat to market. In the picture 1.1, you can see the block cart streaming into the market, each carrying loads of wheat. The traders at the market buy the wheat and sell it further to the shopkeepers in the towns and cities. Tejpal Singh, the large farmer, has surplus of 350 quintals of wheat from all his lands. He sells the surplus wheat at the Raiganj market and has good earnings. As I told you, what does Tejpal Singh do this, his earning? Last year, Tejpal Singh had put most of the money in his bank account. Later, he used the savings for lending to farmers like Sajita who were in need of a loan. He also used the savings to arrange for the working capital for farming in the next season. This year, Tejpal Singh. Dear students, here we see that what do big farmers do their surplus crops? So by selling the surplus crops, they deposit money in their accounts in banks, to which they use for working capital in next season of agriculture. They use this money to lend the loan to the small farmers like Sajita. They purchase the agricultural machineries like tractors, pump sets, etc. Like Tejpal Singh, other large and medium farmers sell the surplus farm products. A part of the earning is saved and kept for buying capital for the next season. Thus, they are able to arrange for the capital for farming from their own savings. Some farmers might also use the savings to buy cattle, trucks, or to set up shops, as well as seed. These constitute the capital for non-farm activities. And these large farmers and medium farmers use these surplus crops and the surplus earnings to set up the non-farm activities like means of transport, buying means of transport.